Welcome back to your daily bedtime story. Tonight's story is Mr. Hare Meets Mr. Mandela by Chris Van Vick, illustrated by Paddy Bomer. Mr. Hare crept out of his forest home. The morning sky was blue, the grass was green, the trees swayed in the cool breeze. The forest was full of songs of birds. But on his doormat lay something he'd never seen before. A brand new 200 rand note. Mr. Hare picked it up. What is Mr. Leopard doing here? He turned around. Aha! Mr. Mandela, he cried. One ear curled up and down. As he thought, he looked up at Miss Secretary Bird, who was watching him from a branch in the thorn tree. "Please call a meeting of all the animals," he said. "I have an important announcement to make." She flew off, calling, "Meet everyone at the baobab tree this morning. Meet everyone." "What is it this time?" everyone wondered, forming a circle under the tree. Mr. Hare stood in the center. He cleared his throat and began. "Fellow citizens of the forest, I have important news for you. This," he said as he waved the 200 rand note around, "has landed on my doormat. I don't know what it is or what it means, but it has Mr. Mandela's face on it, so I'm sure it belongs to him."
"It has my face too," said Mr. Leopard with a playful snarl. "So maybe it belongs to me." Everyone laughed. Except for Mr. Hare. He was in no mood for jokes. "I plan to go to the city this very hour to return this important note to Mr. Mandela." "What?" Mr. Buffalo asked, shocked. "Will you get lost then?" "Why would I get lost?" asked Mr. Hare, pushing out his chest. "Because you can't read," said Mr. Rhino, pointing his sharp horn at Mr. Hare.
"Oh, nonsense, sir," snorted Mr. Hare.
"It's true," Mrs. Elephant stomped her foot impatiently. "In the city of readers, everyone can read. Those who cannot read are learning to read."
"Well, what would happen to me?" Mr. Hare asked.
Mr. Lion leapt forward, swishing his tail in his face.
"Those who cannot read repeat their mistakes over and over again," he growled. "And so will you."
Mr. Hare snickered. "Not me, Kitty!"
With those words, he marched fiercely underneath Mrs. Elephant. Then he skipped down the path that led to the city of readers. Soon he began to hear the noises of the city, and then he saw it. He'd never been in the city before. He glanced at Mr. Leopard's face on the note. It seemed to be warning him not to go.
"But I'm a little wise one," Mr. Hare said. "I am cleverer by far than anyone in the city of readers." And with a leap, he entered the city. People he saw rushing for a train and joined them. At the pay station, a man in the smart uniform, standing behind a counter, held out his hand and Mr. Hare said, holding up the 200 rand note, "I'm on my way to see Mr. Mandela." Man grabbed the note out of his paw.
"Hey!"
Mr. Hare protested. Then the man handed him a 100 rand note. Hare examined the note on the train. It turned blue, he said, puzzled. "And Mr. Buffalo has taken Mr. Leopard's place." He turned the note around.
"But Mr. Mandela is still here."
He took a carrot out of his pocket and nibbled happily, watching the scenery outside.
"Excuse me, sir."
Hare looked up at a man in a blue uniform.
"You're not allowed to eat on the train. Can't you read that?"
He pointed to a sign above Mr. Hare's ears that read, "Please do not eat on the train." Mr. Hare said, putting the half-eaten carrot back in his pocket. He got off at the next station and soon found himself on a busy street. Bratutsi watched Mr. Hare trying to cross the road and saw what he had in his paw.
100, he said, licking his lips. He walked up to Mr. Hare. You seem lost, my brother, he grinned. I'm Brad Tootsie, here to help new visitors to our city. I'm Mr. Hare, he shook hands, and I'm on my way to Mr. Mandela. Mr. Hare said, to give him this. He held out the banknote. Ah, said Brad Tootsie. Mandela is my best friend. I'll take it to him. He grabbed the 100 rand and disappeared into the crowd. Mr. Hare was not happy about how things were going. He wanted to meet Mandela himself and shake his hand. No, he decided. I must find Brad Tootsie and take back the note. And there he is. Mr. Hare spotted Brad Tootsie in Murphy's Peri Peri Chicken Shop, chomping away on 50 rand box of wild wings. Hey, Brad Tootsie, Mr. Hare said. Give me back my note. Brad Tootsie got such a fright that some peri-peri sauce got stuck in his throat, giving him a fit of hiccups. Here it is, he said, handing over a 50 rand note. Pink, Mr. Hare held up the note, puzzled. And what happened to Mr. Buffalo? But here's Mr. Lion to tell me that I need to read to survive in the city. He turned it around. But at least Mr. Mandela is still here. Mr. Hare saw people standing in a taxi queue. Behind them, at the taxi shelter, was a picture of Mr. Mandela. Ah, Mr. Hare said. They must all be going to visit Mr. Mandela too. He joined the queue. When the taxi came, he got in. Where does Mandela live? He asked the driver. At the end of the long walk to freedom, my friend, he said with a friendly smile. Oh, thank you there. They rode for half an hour, past a school, street hawkers, down a highway, past a church, through a suburb. Finally, the driver stopped at a taxi rank. You'll stop, my friend, said the driver. Just walk up the road until you get to a big house with a big gate, with a guard outside the gate. That'll be 30 rand. He took out the 50 rand note out of Mr. Hare's paw. Mr. Hare was about to protest when, "Your change, sir," the driver shoved a note in his paw. Mr. Hare looked at the new note. Again, it was different from the last one. Instead of Mrs. Lion, it was Mr. Elephant. He stared out at him. But when he turned it around, there was Mr. Mandela still smiling. Mr. Hare smiled back and began to hop up the long road. On his way, he passed a bakery. He stopped and sniffed the air. Oh, what was that lovely smell? He pressed his face flat against the bakery window and gazed at the donuts, pancakes, pies, tarts, fruitcakes, biscuits. Mr. Hare hopped into the shop.
Can I help you, sir?
Said a lady behind the counter. I'd like one of these, he said, pointing to the donuts. One of these. He showed her a slice of milk tart, then a wedge of the chocolate cake, a biscuit, apple crumble, a Cookster. Oh. Please, sir, you have to make up your mind. Mr. Hare finally pointed to a Chelsea bun. Ah, the lady smiled. Good choice. She slipped the Chelsea bun into a packet and handed it to him. The next thing he knew, Mr. Mandela's brown note was in her hands. Then put it back in his paw. It was green. And who do you think had taken the place of Mr. Elephant? There was Mr. Rhino warning him about the city of readers. Mr. Hare skipped out of the shop, taking big bites out of his Chelsea bun and wondering how many times will Mr. Mandela's note change colour before I meet him. Then he saw the guard at the big gate. Skipped up to the gate, greeted him and asked, does Mr. Mandela live here?
Yes, he does.
I'm Mr. Hare of the African Bush, and I have an important note for him. The guard said,
do you have an appointment?
No, said Mr. Hare, I have note. The guard turned and spoke into an intercom.
So I have Mr. Hare from the forest?
A deep, crackling voice onto the intercom.
Mr. Hare! The great Mr. Hare! hair of the African bush.
Yes, Mr. Mandela.
Well, send him in. It was a great meeting. The big hand of Mr. Mandela shaking the paw of the famous Mr. Hare. The two men entertained each other with stories of the city and the bush, of lions and heroes, of freedom and adventure.
Then Mr. Hare
told Mr. Mandela why I'd come. I found this note in my doorstep, he said, handing over the turnaround note. It has changed colour so many times, and the faces of my big friends from the bush have appeared on it. I knew it was yours, so I came to give it to you myself. Mr. Mandela was puzzled, but he accepted the note with a smile. A photographer came to take pictures of Mr. Mandela and Mr. Hare, and a TV crew came to film them for News at 6. When Hare came home, he called a meeting. He told all the animals about his exciting adventures. He told them about the people he'd met, the places he'd seen, and how he had finally met Mr. Mandela. And my friends, he said, looking smugly at lion and elephant, and buffalo and leopard and rhino. I did all this without being able to read one word. And with that, the sun set, all the animals went back to their homes for a good night's rest.
The next morning,
Mr. Hare was awakened by a thud on his doorstep. What was that, he wondered? Maybe it's an angry stomp of Mrs. Elephant coming to argue with me. Peeked outside. Mrs. Elephant wasn't there, but there was a big envelope on his mat. He went out and looked around to see who had brought it. There was no one in sight. Mr. Hare opened the envelope. It was a letter.
Dear Mr. Hare, the whole country is still talking about your visit. Thank you for telling me all those stories. Returning the 10 rand note. I've enclosed a 200 rand note for you to spend the next time you visit the city. Warm regards, Nelson Mandela.
Because he could not read, Mr. Hare was not interested in the letter, but something fell out of the envelope and fluttered onto the mat.
Mr. Hare looked at the 200 rand note. He could not believe his eyes.
I don't believe it, he cried. The very same place as yesterday morning.
Without wasting time, he called another meeting of all his animals.
My friends, he announced. It's a great mystery. The note has returned. He waved it around for all to see. I have to journey back to Mr. Mandela to return it to him. And without another word, he was away, skipping down the path to the city of readers.
The end.
Sleep tight. And don't let the bed bugs bite.